Hey there, Vine Nation. Welcome back to Game Vine, and my name is Dave. Give me 1 second. I need to grab my Surge. I grabbed it. You thought I was talking about an energy drink, didn't you? Nope. It's a controller. Let's check it out. Now, this is the Surge controller. I heard about this first on another YouTuber's channel, and I wanted to see it for myself. And boy, this has a lot of stuff going on with it. First of all, let's get into the comfortability. It is pretty comfortable. I like how the sticks extend down, and the pad is actually like a Xbox controller shape. So it's got the best of like PlayStation extended grip, and the big bulkiness of the Xbox, so you can have all the buttons where you need them. So that's a plus in my book. The other cool thing is it has buttons like everywhere. You can map anything you want. Grenades, you want them back here. You want shooting on the very back of the grips. Well, you can have that. You got two buttons back here. I mean, it's insane. And it even has the turbo, so that's super cool. It has motion control. It has decent vibration. It's the old school vibration, so it's going to give you a but yeah, you know, it's okay. Sometimes though, I would have it hooked up to the wire, because sometimes it died, so I'd hook it up with the wire to my Switch, and when I turned off my Switch, it just would go crazy when it vibrated. So I don't know what the hell that was about, but I don't know. And the battery life is about 8 hours. It's not too bad. It's kind of in the middle there. Now the build quality, solid. Great plastic. It's got a nice heft to it, not too heavy. And because the extended grips are longer, there's a focal point on each one of your hands, so it's nice and balanced and it doesn't feel too heavy, but still has enough weight to it. So that's perfect in my book. Sticks are a little small, but that would be my only gripe with this right now. They still have a good material. The buttons, I don't like the buttons. That would be the only two gripes I would say, is the sticks are a tiny bit small and the buttons have this like slickness to them. I wish they had more of a like matte finish to them. The D-pad is surprisingly awesome, spongy, responsive, able to hit diagonals really well. The triggers are longer response button press, and the top two here are, I don't really like the top two. They don't feel like I'm hitting them sometimes. So I have three gripes. Sticks too small, glossy buttons no, and the R1 and L1 buttons aren't as responsive as I would like them. The back two are okay though, I like those. And it's pretty much perfect to play any game you want. So you wanna play Smash Brothers? Good. You wanna play Eraser? Good. You wanna play old school games? Good. You wanna play some smups? Anything you want. This is an all-around controller, and I was super surprised, even though I was new going into it. I have seen reviews on this, and people said this was a great controller, but I just had to find out for myself. But with that being said, I highly, highly recommend this. The price on it isn't too high. I got it for like 35 bucks. There's going to be a link down below if you want to check it out and get it for yourself. But if you need a controller and you want one, I would say for medium to larger size hands, this is one that you want to get. Get the Surge. So, until the next time that I see you, Vine Nation, I appreciate you stopping on by. And please click like if you like the video. And if you're new, click subscribe. If you don't like the video, click dislike and tell me down in the comments below why you don't, so I can improve the videos in the future. But until the next time that I see you, have a great rest of your day and a great time with all that you play. Get Surged. Bye, guys. Miko, it's time to go. Good girl, Miko.